Hey guys, welcome to this mentoring session. Today I'm going to tell you about how you can become successful solutions architect or cloud solution architect, or you can call pre-sales consultant. So in this session today, we are going to discuss about what is architect organization, what is solution architect function, job descriptions of cloud architect, how you can become a cloud architect, and tools useful for cloud architect. So before we move to the details of solution architect role, let's understand what all roles the organization has. Okay, I'm trying to explain here in this slide. As you can see here on the top of the screen, it says big picture. Big picture means the business goals. So the business goals is led by the C-level enterprise architect. They are like CEO or the CTO who have the business goals. So to translate this goal into reality, or you can say to achieve these goals, what they need a business strategy, right? And who does this business strategy for them? It's done by the business architect, right? So at the bottom of the screen, if you can see, I have mentioned their details like business, focus, and technology. So the business architect would be focused on business. And what he needs is a team to achieve this focus, right? So then we have another team of architects who help them. So if you can see here, this is like the infrastructure architect who is more into technologies. And though he has some business knowledge, but he's more into technologies. Then there is a software architect who would be designing the software, or you can say the product, which would help to achieve the business goal. In fact, the entire business would be based on this product. So this software architect would be focused on the product. And then comes the solution architect. The solution architect is actually a kind of bridge between all three. So he should have the business knowledge, he should have the product knowledge, and he should have the technical knowledge as well. So in next slide, we are going to understand what the roles are. So we just learned about the basically the five types of architect in an organization. So let's understand a little more about these roles. Let's see. As I said, there is a big picture of business goal that is led by the CEO or the CTO, and then there is a business strategist, or you can say the business architect, who helped them to strategize this business. Now, let's understand more about software architect. So the software architect has mastered the value, use, development, and delivery of software intensive system. Mind it, it's not an easy task, right? So they have developed a skill in software development lifecycle, software engineering, and software design. And these architects are the ones who communicate to all the level of management about the software concept. So as you can see, the software architect is someone who has more detail of the solution and more technology, and they are tightly focused on the end objective. And the end objective is product. Let's now talk about the infrastructure architect. So the infrastructure architect provides strategic use of infrastructure, network, and operations as an asset. They create and deliver technology strategies to optimize the use of technology resources related to hardware and physical system. The infrastructure architect use their mastery of network computing platform and operation to guide the organization to valuable investment in hardware and software. So as you can see, the infrastructure architect is someone who is more technical. Let's talk about the solution architect. Now this solution architect is responsible for delivery of one or more projects within the scope of business case for the solution, right? So these architects understand the business unit and organization, and they bridge the gap between solution architect team, business architect, and work to ensure alignment between business strategies and the information technology roadmap throughout the project lifecycle, right? So now we have a fair idea about all the roles. So, but this session is more about the solution architect. So let's understand who is solution architect and how they work. So who is the solution architect? Solution architect is a combination of role, process, and documentation that is intended to address specific problems and requirements, usually through the design of a specific information system of application. So what is solution architecting, guys? Right? So solution architecting is basically rigorous design methodology that consistently yields the right level of technical design documentation and develop technical solution that conforms both to customer requirement and solution development standards. So the solution proposed and designed by solution architect should be agile and must address non-functional concerns around performance, scalability, security, and availability. Great. So an individual performing the role of a solution architect focuses on converting requirements into the architecture and design that ultimately constitute the blueprint of the solution. In that process, the solution architect relies usually on design pattern from the previous engagement, the lesson learned during previous engagement, right? Published reference architecture, and on guidance with enterprise architecture, right? In their efforts, solution architects balance architectural concerns of the project with the concerns of the enterprise. So, all right, guys, now I hope you understand what is solution architect, what are the roles, and how you can become a solution architect, what quality you should be looking for. So, the solution architect is often the development team leader, means as such, they are often expected to provide motivation and guidance to the entire development team during the system development lifecycle. The solution architect must ensure buy-in from the development team so that the team is motivated to match the detailed design of the solution to the higher level architecture. The extent to which a solution architect's work drives from an enterprise architect's roadmap may vary from 0 to 100%. Where the solution architect starts and stops depends on the funding model for the process of solution identification and delivery. For example, an enterprise may employ a solution architect on a feasibility study or to prepare a solution vision or solution outline for an initiative to a tender. A supplier may employ a solution architect at bid time before any implementation or project is costed or resourced, but both of them employ a solution architect to govern and employ an implementation project or play a leading role within it. So let's have an example which shows how solution architect defines the solution. Just looking at the stake here, you got an idea how solution architect defines the solution in different scenarios. In case of on-prem IT infrastructure, the solution stack consists of all the way from data center itself to the application and in between various other components. There's so many things, so many under architecture and so many expertise. It's not only about the code, it's about the environment as well, like physical thing, right? Such as network hardware. So I would say that successful solution architect has really broad understanding of technical things within the IT space. So it's a bit complicated, I understand. It requires years of expertise. But today going forward, it's lots about the cloud. How can do things as service, right? And then your role as a solution architect might be, how do you define to get in the purchase the software as a service, or how do you define and the non-functional requirement, and how do you communicate toward various layers like database, network, security? So I hope, guys, it's more clear to you now what is the role of solution architect and in this changing scenario, how it is modified or changed. So as I said, nowadays it's more about clouds. So you can log into any job portal and you can see how much cloud architects are in demand. Here are the few examples. You would see here how the customer or from the vendors both need solution architect or I can say cloud architect. So the role taxonomy described this way. First, the infrastructure specialist, then the infrastructure architect, the data center architect, and then cloud architect. This is the taxonomy of the cloud architecture. Now let's understand the core skills of cloud architect in the next slide. So let's understand core skill set of cloud architects. So the core skill set of cloud architect or the solution architect range from the knowledge of hardware and software component and the equal component on cloud. For example, the solution architect should know the server hardware types like tower server, rack mounted server, or the blade server with the compute capacity, while the cloud architect must know the different virtualized instances offered on cloud. For example, large or micro instance on AWS, A to D series on Azure. So the cloud architect must know the network equivalent on cloud, example VPC, and they should also they are also expected to know the storage offering on the cloud for S3, AWS Glacier, or blob storage on Azure. So the cloud architecture should also know the different operating system like open source, Windows, and how to manage the continuous integration, continuous development tool like Azure DevOps, AWS Pipeline, AWS System Manager, etc. So they are also expected to know the different security and performance component. So one of the most important skill set of the cloud architect is they must know how to estimate the cloud BOM, so that is bill of material. Since it is subscription-based service, documentation is also one of the prime job of cloud architect. So guys, I hope now you understand the solution architect and how the role is changed in the current scenario and where the cloud is the hot cake in the market. So now let's talk about how you can become a solution architect and what expertise you should have, what you should do. So first of all, you should increase your technical breadth and then personal development. You must have a mentor who can guide you through and then participate in networking events because that helps you to grow your knowledge and understanding of the changing scenario, what customer wants, what business requires, what new technology is coming up, what the competition have. And finally, you must achieve your certificate. Here are a few tools that would help you with the cost and other things. Cloud architect, like most of the cloud service have their own calculator. Here is for AWS and Azure, I have mentioned on the screen. However, any cloud service provider comes up with their own calculator. And here are some reference article. If you want them separately, you can comment here. I will send you this article and more documents that you can learn about it. And here is TCO calculator. That is again one important thing. So I guess now we have enough understanding of the roles and what all you should have to become a solution architect, how the role is changing in this current scenarios, and what all documents or tools can help you here. So in the next session, I'll talk more about these tools and would be talking more about designing tools that would actually help you to design and draw the architect. All right, thank you so much for joining in, and please do not forget to like and subscribe my channel and do comment if you need any further support. Thank you. Bye.